Oh, but the difference between the front and the back?
Yeah, maybe I need a thumb tap to check it.
Sounds like you're speaking through your phone, not through your microphone. Is it plugged into the computer?
Yeah. Is it better?
You have it plugged into the computer? Radha Madhava. Maybe we have to figure this out another time. Just you and me.
Okay.
Say something.
Hi, Krishna. Good morning.
No, it's not working at all. Yeah. You have to unplug it because we don't hear you. We'll have to do another time.
Okay.
Okay. So you can unplug it. Now she can't hear anything. Once she plugged in the microphone, she can't even hear me. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare.
Okay.
Not working properly. I think someone may have to call her on the phone and tell her that it's not connected properly and we can't hear her.
Hare Krishna.
I think Leela Rani, you're going to have to translate because she doesn't know that we don't hear her.
Okay. Jamuna, 我们听不, Jamuna, 你那边麦克风连接好了吗? 我们现在听不到你的声音。
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
I don't hear anybody. Leela Rani, can you say something? I don't hear you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
有声音吗?
I barely hear you.
有。
Oh, well, I'm sorry.
是雇主没有带耳麦，他听不到我们的声音。Okay,
Jumana Priya, say something.
Hare Krishna, good morning.
Yeah, the microphone's not working. Okay, so you and I have to meet another time so I can help you set up that microphone.
Okay.
Yeah. You can unplug it. It's not properly working yet. Okay. So, we had talked about the law of Dharma last week.
上周呢，我们来谈论的有关这个大麻法则。
And when you stick to your Dharma, you can overcome your whimsical feelings about how you're feeling in the moment.
就是当你去依附于坚守大麻法则的时候，你就可以克服，就是你这个随心所欲，只是感情用事的这种状态。We'd
given the example of Arjuna, basically told Krishna, "I don't feel like fighting," and Krishna said, "You should do it as your duty, no matter how you feel."
就是呢，我们举了一个例子，就是 Krishna 呢，他要求 Arjuna 要去作战，但是呢 ，Arjuna 却不愿意作战。这时候呢 ，Krishna 就对 Arjuna 说：“你只需要去履行你的职责。”That
some people say, well, if I don't feel like doing it and I do it, then it's artificial. It's not real. So I should only do it if I feel it.
有的人呢，可能就辩解说，如果我真的不 关去做，然后呢，我就去做了，因为我真的没有感受到这一点，那么就是这看起来有一点矫揉造作。But
then you may wait for lifetimes before you feel like doing it.
那么这可能就是当你真正喜欢去做这件事情的时候，可能要等上一生的时间。Krishna
says, "Do this. I'll do it when I feel like it. Maybe in this lifetime I'll never feel like it, so then I never do it."
Krishna 就说呢，你去做，然后呢，你就说你不喜欢，这样做，那么你要等到，就是当你喜欢去做的时候，你才去做，那可能就是需要等上一生的时间。Young
Galian, turn off your mic.
杨改莲，就是可以把你的这个麦克风先关一下。Thank
you. So Krishna is telling Arjuna, well, if you don't feel like it, you can still do it. You don't have to wait till you feel like it.
所以呢, Krishna 就告诉 Arjuna 说, 即便你不喜欢这样做, 你仍然需要这样做, 你没有必要等到你,
and so Prabhupada explained that the whole process of bhakti is that you do something even if you don't feel like it, and by doing that, you'll start to feel like doing it. The desire develops by doing it.
就这个方案瑜伽的程序呢，就是说，即便你不喜欢去做，但是呢，你仍然去做了。然后呢，通过你去做这件事情，这个过程本身就可以发展起来你喜欢去做的这种。 这种情感，这就是我们方案的一个程序。So
there's sometimes we think, well, I have to be in the right mood, I have to have the right consciousness to do it, which is true, but I'll finish the but after you translate.
有时候呢，我们就说，我真的就是。 不喜欢做这件事情，只有我等到有这样的心态或者有这样的知觉的时候，我才愿意去做。但是
，But we're not always in the right mood. That's the problem.
我们呢不总是处在这个很恰当的心态当中，这就是我们的问题。So
just like when I teach japa, I always teach you should be in a certain mood to chant.
就像当我教你们念诵加帕的时候呢，我就告诉你们说，你应该以一种恰当的心态去念诵。And
even we know the mood, sometimes we're just not in the mood.
即便有时候我们知道我们真的不是处在恰当的心态当中。So
maybe you tell me, today I didn't chant any rounds, and I say why, and you say, because I wasn't in the mood.
那么出现的结果可能就是说，今天你告诉我说，你根本就没有念诵你的加法。我问你为什么呢？你说因为我没有处在恰当的心态当中。Could
you imagine a devotee saying, "Today I wasn't vegetarian," and you say why? You say, "I was in the mood for some meat."
然后呢，有奉献的，就是你告诉其他人说。 你说我今天没有成为这个素食者，其他人就问你为什么呢？因为我今天就是处在一个不恰当的心态当中，我就吃了一肉。So
on one hand, bhakti is all about the proper mood, but on the other hand, in the beginning, we don't always have the proper mood, so we have to act even if we're not feeling the proper mood.
所以呢，这个 bhakti 呢，一方面我们确实在履行方案服务的时候需要恰当的心态，同时呢，我们也知道我们并不总是有这种恰当的心态，所以呢，我们就去行动，以发展起这样恰当的心态。So
that's the whole theme of the second chapter.
所以呢，这就是整个第二章的主题。Arjuna
is saying, I don't want to fight.
Arjuna 说我不想去作战.
Krishna is saying, fight, it's your duty.
Krishna 就说呢，你要去作战，因为这是你的职责.
I don't want to fight.
我真的不想去打战.
You must fight.
你必须要作战.
But, you know no buts, you must fight.
我不想作战，但是。 你必须要去作战，所以呢。And
he had many buts, many buts.
Arjuna 呢，他有很多很多的但是，很多很多的借口。So
in that second chapter, Krishna is stressing dharma, duty. This is what you are supposed to do. So do it.
所以呢，在第二章中呢，Krishna 他就。 强调了有关 Dharma 的法则，就是作为你的职责，你一定要去履行你的职责去作战。And
then you have other verses in the Gita where it said, if you give up your duty because it's difficult or troublesome, then that is in the modes of passion and the modes of ignorance.
而且呢, Krishna 还继续说, 如果有余, 害怕这个麻烦, 或者觉得困难, 你放弃了你的这个职责, 那么你就处在这个激情或者愚昧形态当中。
And if you do your duty, even if it's difficult, then that's the mode of goodness.
即便是面临着困难, 但是你仍然去履行你的职责, 那么这就是处在善良形态当中。
So there's, throughout the Gita, you can see this theme. It's very interesting. This theme is always coming up.
所以呢,就是纵览整部佛家梵歌,可以看到就是有关这个主题,其实是贯穿始终的。And
what's so interesting about this is if you contrast it, you contrast the concept of Dharma with what's happening in the world, especially maybe in the last 50 years and especially in the last 10 or 15.
所以呢就有关这个大马法则呢,如果我们就是来看当今世界的发生的情况,尤其是近50年,近10年,15年所发生的当今世界发生的事情。
And we see what's happening is there's amongst the younger generation is a rejection of tradition.
我们可以看到在年轻一代当中呢,就存在着他们反传统的这么一个现象。
You see the old people and you say, oh, that's what the old people do. We don't do that.
当我们看到那些老年人,就是老一辈他们在做的事情的时候呢,我们总是说,哎呀,这都是老过时的了,是他们老年人做的事情。
The modern culture is all about so-called freedom. Do what makes you happy.
现在的这个文明呢,就是被称为是所谓的这个自由, 那么你就是去做你喜欢做的事情。
Isn't it?
是吗?
Especially with this generation now.
尤其是在现在的这一代。
They want to be free, do whatever they want.
人们想自由, 想要随心所欲地去做他们喜欢做的事情。
In Varnashram or Vedic culture, everything is governed by Shastric injunction. In modern culture, it's governed more based on what makes you feel good.
就是在这个伟达这个传统当中呢,就是人们需要去做什么是由这个经典所给予的这些指导,但是呢,在现在社会呢,人们去做什么只是他想要做什么,他感觉喜欢去做什么,那就去做什么。
So you have this contrast.
所以呢,就是有这样的一个矛盾。
What I want to do and what the Shastra says I should do. Sometimes they're opposed to one another.
所以呢,就存在着我喜欢想要去做的事情和经典想要我做的事情,那么在两者之间呢,有时候是相反的。
And people nowadays, they're not so trained to follow this kind of authority. It's just not considered that this will make you happy. It'll make you happy if you're free to think the way you want to think and do what you want and do new things that have never been done before.
现在的人们就是害怕这个追随权威,害怕这个伊斯兰的这个权威,然后呢人们更害怕呢,他们就是害怕去没有这种自由,去做他们喜欢做的事情,去做他们就是想要创新的去做他们喜欢做的事情。
Now, there's another interesting point.
还有另外一个非常有意思的一个观点。That
in the Gita, Krishna is teaching Arjuna that your success is going to be that you stick to your dharma, irrespective of whether there's external success or external failure.
真的在这个佛家梵歌当中呢, Krishna就是跟阿尔朱娜说, 你只要去坚守你的这个达玛法则, 不管外在你是成功还是失败, 你都会受到尊重的。
you know, there's a verse in the Gita, and Krishna says, well, if you win, you'll get the kingdom. And if you die, you go to heaven. So either way, if you do your dharma, you'll win in some way. You'll win in some way if you do your dharma.
就在《Bhagavad-Gita》中呢，有一个师姐，Krishna就说，如果你战胜的话呢，你将荣享这个王国；如果你战败的话呢，你将飞升天堂。那么就是Krishna说，不管是以某一种结果，你看起来都是赢了。如果你只是履行你的职责的话。So
Krishna is putting stress on duty over success.
所以呢，Krishna他把这个职责看得比这个成功要重要的多。Just
like when Prabhupada came to America, when he was coming to America, he wasn't sure that the Americans would take to Krishna consciousness.
当初圣帕巴的去到美国的时候呢，他并不确定这些美国人他们会接受Krishna的直觉。
But because he wasn't sure, it didn't mean that he was thinking, well, maybe I shouldn't go to America because I'm not sure if they'll take it. He came anyway.
因为帕帕的呢，他并没有因为就是这些美国人是否接受Krishna的知觉，他不确定他是否会成功，所以呢，没有因此而没有去履行他的职责。
So what was Prabhupada thinking?
So Prabhupada的想法是什么呢?
You're going to come all the way to America, risk your life, and you may fail? That doesn't seem practical. Why would you do that?
就是你去到美国的话呢，并不能 一定会成功，有可能你会失败。你呢，甚至是冒着生命的危险，你一路历尽艰辛。那么，你为什么会这样做呢？
So Prabhupada was thinking, I may not be successful, but the real success is that I've been ordered to do this, and I must come and try. That's my success. That's dharma.
帕巴勒就想。 可能就说我不一定能够取得成功，但是呢，我得到了这样的训示，我需要走出去，需要去传教。那么我这样去做就是我的成功。But
it's interesting in the Manu Samhita, which is a law book of Dharma, it says if you do your Dharma, you will be successful. Wherever there is dharma, there is success.
就在Manu Samhita?
Manu Samhita当中呢，他就说，Manu
Samhita中就说，如果你去履行你的这个职责，如果你坚守你的大马法则的话呢，你始终都是成功的。I'll
explain why.
我来解释一下为什么。One
second. We need paper.
我们需要一个纸。I
have to draw a picture.
我需要画一下。We
call this the circle of Dharma.
这被称为是Dharma的这个圆圈。Okay,
so what's outside the circle of Dharma?
就是Dharma法则这个圆圈之外是什么呢?
If you step outside the circle of Dharma, then everything outside that circle is where sinful activities go on.
那么呢，在这个达玛法则之外呢，就是罪恶的这些活动。
So if you stay inside the circle, you'll be successful. When you go outside the circle, then you start to fail.
所以呢，你只要是在这个达玛法则里面，你就是成功的。当你走出达玛法则这个圆圈之外的话呢，你就是失败了。
You know all these companies in America that were dishonest and they lost everything.
你们知道美国的一些企业呢，他们非常的不诚实，然后呢，其实他们就失去了一切。
So there's this idea.We want to get inside our head that if I do my dharma, if I do what's right, that's real success. And if I try to become successful by going outside the circle of dharma, then I'm basically stabbing myself. I'm undermining my own welfare.
What's the last sentence?
Stab. If I try to be successful going outside the circle of dharma, then I'm basically like putting a knife in my...I'm harming myself.
就是说如果我只要是
inside the circle, I'll be successful. If I try to be successful by going outside the circle, then I'm harming myself.
Okay. 就是只要我在这个达玛法则这个圆圈之内呢，我坚守达玛法则，那么我就是成功的。如果我想获得成功，但是呢，我却走出了这个达玛法则，在这之外去行为的话呢，那么我就相当于就是拿刀，然后去伤害自己。我就是在做着伤害自己的事情。
Because sometimes it seems like if I just compromise on dharma, I could be more successful. I could either in Krishna consciousness or.In my private life.
因为有时候呢，看起来不管是在 Krishna 知觉当中，还是在我的个人生活、私人生活当中，如果我跟达玛法则相妥协的话呢，看起来我似乎会更加成功。
Like Evia, you sometimes a person is tempted to be dishonest.In order to achieve something.
有时候呢，就是有些人可能为了获得某些事情呢，他会短暂的变得比较就是不真诚。
Especially in business.
尤其在这个商业当中。
So. And in the end of the Gita.Then Sanjay said, wherever there's Krishna and Arjuna, there's morality.
在这个《宝剑梵歌》的结尾之处呢，Sanjay就说，哪里有Krishna, 哪里有这个Arjuna, 哪里就会有道德。
There's Dharma.
哪里就有这个宗教。
And because of that, they'll be victorious, but your sons are a dharmic, and they're going to lose. Because Dharma always wins over a Dharma.
所以呢，就是哪里就会有胜利。但是呢，你的儿子就是指这个对待 Rashtra 的，他的儿子呢是这个反宗教的。所以呢，你的儿子注定会失败，因为无论在哪里，这个宗教法则总会战胜于这个非宗教。
It's like the historical light over darkness, good against evil. That's Bhagavad Gita. Dhritarashtra and his sons, Duryodhan, they're the evil. Krishna and Arjuna are the good. They do dharma. The other ones do adharma, and they lose because they're adharmic.
所以呢，就是纵览这个历史，就是无论任何时候，这个光明总会战胜黑暗，这个善良总会战胜这个邪恶。所以呢，因为这个。对他儿子的他的儿子独优蛋呢，他们是属于非宗教的邪恶的一方，所以呢，他们最终会战败。
So, I want to show you a very practical benefit of being dharmic.
所以呢，我想跟你们展示一下，当你们变得具有宗教心的话呢，旅行达玛的时候，你们将会得到的非常实际的这个好处。
Human nature is.That we put things off that we don't like doing.
人类的这个天性呢，通常会拖延他们不想去做的事情。
Do you have anything that you've put off that you should be doing, but you don't because it makes you feel uncomfortable or it's difficult?
你们在生活当中有没有就是说你们本来应该去做的事情，但是呢，就因为他觉得让你感到不舒服或你不喜欢，所以呢，你就拖延不去做它，有没有类似的一个经历？
Can you think of something you should be doing that you just keep putting off because it's not fun or it's difficult?
你们能不能想象一件就是说 有一件你们需要应该去做的事情，但是呢，由于你觉得困难，或者是呢，它让你感到不太舒服，或者你不喜欢去做，你就一直不断的在拖延。
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Sure.
Yeah. So on a very practical level, if we become a little more dharmic, it becomes a little easier to do these things we don't like to do because they should be done. And so we just do them.
所以呢，如果我们更加就是具有宗教心的话呢，就是有些事情即便我们不喜欢去做，但是呢，我们仍然会去做。
There's a verse in the Gita where Krishna tells Arjuna, well, you should do it because it ought to be, it's like the right thing to do. That's why you should do it. Even if you don't want to do it, it's the right thing. So that's what it means to be dharmic. You just do it even if you don't like it because it ought to be done.
所以呢，就是在《薄伽梵歌》当中呢，Krishna就告诉阿尔朱纳说，你需要去做正确的事情，即便你不想去做，因为这是正确的事情。那么你这样去做的话呢，你就说明，你具有这个宗教之心，即便你真的不喜欢做。
Jimena Priya, sometimes I say it longer than you have to say it because I want to make sure you understand. But then if you want, you can shorten it.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes I just want to make sure you understand what I'm saying. But then
once
you understand, if you want to make it shorter, you can.
Okay.
As long as you cover everything I say. Yeah.
Okay.
One of the very practical thing. On the material level, it's very important that in your life you do what's important first, not what you like first.
非常实际的一点就是说，在现实当生活当中呢，我们也是应当首先去做那些对我们来说重要的事情，而不是说我们喜欢去做的事情。
I guarantee you, if you adopt this one principle of every day, do what is most important in your material life and your spiritual life, rather than what you feel like doing, you will notice a big difference in your life.
我会呢，向你保证，如果你真的每一天呢，先优先去做那些重要的事情，不管是在你的灵性生活还是物质生活当中。 那么一段时间之后，你肯定会发现你的生活大不相同。
It's time to exercise. Oh, I don't feel like it. I'll do it later. And then you never do it.
就比如说这个运动，你不喜欢运动，然后呢，你就一直推，你就想着以后再运动吧。那么可能你永远都不会去运动了。
In one sense, you can say dharma is like discipline because if you're dharmic, you'll do what you're supposed to do, even if it's difficult and even if you don't feel like it.
所以呢，另一方面来说呢，这个dharma它就意味着这个纪律，就是即便你不喜欢去做某事，然后你仍然去做它，因为你知道这是你应该去做的。So
that's where this verse comes in, where Krishna tells Arjuna, you do it because it ought to be done. You do it because it's the right thing. So that we should memorize that. I do it because it's the right thing.
所以呢，我们应该谨记这一点，就是说我之所以去做这件事情，因为这是我应该做的，而且这是正确的事情，这也是Krishna在《薄伽梵歌》当中教导阿尔朱纳的。So
the next lesson is on detachment, and detachment and dharma, they work together.
下一个法则呢，就是有关这个超脱，就是不依附的这个法则，它跟这个达玛法则是，相辅相成的。
Because one of the principles of surrender is not to do something that you like to do, but it's not good for you.
因为这个皈依的一个含义呢，就是你不去做那些你尽管喜欢去做，但是对你却没有意义的事情。
So that requires to not do something you'd like to do, but it is not good for you or good for your spiritual life.
所以呢，就是不去做那些对你的灵性生活无益，却是你喜欢去做的事情。
So Vivian, you say, I really like to do this, and I say, it's not good for your spiritual life, don't do it. So then now you have to detach from that.
所以 Vivian 就是说，就比如说，你喜欢去做某事，但是呢，我却说你做这件事情呢，对你的灵性生活没有什么好处。那么你就需要变得不依附，不要再去做这件事情。
So the Dharma becomes the strength for detachment in some cases.
所以呢，就是在某些情况之下呢，这个Dharma法则呢，就成了你不依附做某事的一个力量的一个源泉。
Because it's my duty both to do something, but also my duty not to do something.
所以呢，这是我的职责。我的职责呢是应该去做某些事情，不应该去做另外的事情。
So Arjun wanted to give up the fight, and Krishna said, "No, it's not favorable."
所以呢，阿尔朱纳想要
He had to detach from that desire. He had to get over that desire.
阿尔朱纳呢，他想放弃作战，但是 Krishna 就告诉他说，你需要变得就是不依附于你的这个愿望，你需要就是说去履行你的职责，你需要去作战，所以你需要克服这一点。
So if we're more dharmic, then we get the ability to do the things we should do, even though we don't want them, and not do the things we shouldn't do, even though we want to do them.
所以呢，如果我们就是具有这个宗教心的话呢，我们应该去做那些尽管我们不想去做，但是我们却是应该做的事情，而且不去做那些我们尽管想要去做，但是却不应该做的事情。
And they're listed in the scripture six.Items or characteristics of surrender, and two of them are these are two items: do what's favorable and avoid what's not favorable.
所以呢，就有关在旅行方案服务当中呢，我们有六种不同的这些原则，其中有两条呢，就是说去做那些有益于方案服务的，去不做不益于方案服务的。
Now there's another benefit of being dharmic.
就是呢，变得具有宗教心，还有另外的这个益处。
There's a sense of fulfillment from doing your duty, even if it's difficult.
就是呢，即便是你面临着困难，但是如果你去履行你的职责的时候呢，仍然会给你带来这个满足的这个，让你感到心满意足。
If something's difficult, then it seems like the easiest thing to do is not do it.
如果某事看起来困难的话呢，就是表面上看起来好像简单的方法就是不去做它。
But if you avoid your dharma, then you're going to feel dissatisfied knowing that you should have done it.
但是呢，如果你想要逃避你的这个 dharma 的话呢，你不去做这些事情的话，你就会感到不满足。
And if the dharma is difficult, but you do it,Then you, after doing it, you'll feel some satisfaction that this is good. I did the right thing, even though it was unpleasant or difficult.
所以呢，就是即便这些事情很困难，或者是呢让你感到不悦不舒服，但是呢你仍然去做了，那么这就会让你感到心满意足。
Okay. Did you ever do something that was difficult and after you did it, you felt really good?
你们有没有做过一些事情，就是 开始的时候你们感觉到真的是特别难的事情，但是你们做过之后，你们就觉得感觉特别良好。
Yes?
有没有这样的体会？
If there's something you should be doing right now and you're not doing it, it actually burdens your mind because you know you should do it, but you're avoiding it. And so you carry this burden around with you all the time. I should do it. I know I should do it. I don't want to. When am I going to do it? I'll do it tomorrow. Tomorrow comes, you never do it. And so you carry a burden around.
就是还有相反的一个情况，就是你知道你应该去做某事，但是呢，你却一直在推，却没有去做。那么呢，其实你就一直带着这样的一个负担，或者是负罪感。然后无论你到哪，无论做任何事情，始终有这么一种负罪感。然后呢，你可能想着，哦，我这个事情还没有去做呢，然后呢，那我就继续推到明天嘛。等到明天了，你还是没有做，那么你的这种负罪感会一直存在的。
Another benefit of Dharma is that no matter what the situation is, if you follow Dharma, you'll always act with integrity. You understand the word integrity?
Yeah, yeah. 就是还有就是你坚守大麻法则的另外一个好处就是，不管你就是。 不管你的情况是什么，你只要是坚守你的大麻法则，你就是正直的。
We all have personal values. So if you're dharmic, you'll always live those values, even when it's difficult, even when it would be easier to compromise those values.
所以呢，我们都有自己的这个价值观，即便呢事情变得很困难的时候，但是呢，如果我们坚守履行。 我们的大马，我们的价值观的话呢，那么我们就是在做着正确的事情，我们就是正直的。如果我们跟大马法的相妥协的话呢，我们就没有坚守自己的价值观。Or
as we said before, even when you could get an immediate result, a better immediate result, if you compromise those principles, you won't do that.
即便就是像我们之前所提到的，你尽管说。 就是妥协你的这个跟你的大麻法的相妥协，你可能会带来更好的这个及时的这个效果这些益处，但是呢，你仍然不会这样做。So
this is all I wanted to say today on the topic of Dharma, and I want to stop now before we go on to the next one. I want to see if you have any questions or comments.
所以呢，这就是我今天跟大家要讲述的有关大麻法则。然后呢，在我们继续讲述下一个主题之前呢，我想问一下你们大家有没有类似的问题。Are
there any questions?
Yeah, I think maybe we can start with the last lecture, the question.
What did you say?
I think maybe we can start with the question from last week.
Okay, questions from last week. Very good.
Okay, 我看一下啊，我等一下啊，我看我们上周还遗留的有大概两三个问题。 Okay, Vivian的问题。 婚姻的职责是什么呢？比如说圣洁、忠诚、照顾好对方或者孩子，是吗？ So what's the dharma of marriage? Is it like a charity, honest, and also take care of our spouse and our children like that?
That's part of it. It's not everything.
啊，这是。 你所提到的这些是婚姻的一部分职责，但是不是全部。
The the scriptures say, if you have children, then your duty as a parent is to train them so they never take birth again.
经典中有言呢，如果你有孩子的话呢，你作为父母的职责就是你要去培养你的孩子，就是以至于他不会再次投生。
Yeah, so some of you have become devotees after you already had children, and so they weren't raised as devotees. So that makes it more, maybe impossible or more difficult.
有些人呢，就是你在成为奉献者之前，可能已经有孩子了，所以呢，这一点对你来说要做到的话，可能更加的困难。
Another principle is that marriage means dharma, that the husband and wife together help one another become religious.
婚姻的另外一个职责呢，就是说丈夫和妻子两个人相互帮助彼此变得更加具有宗教之心。
And of course, some of you were already married before you became devotees, and your husbands may not be interested in religion or interested in Krishna consciousness, so that will limit you to perform that duty.
有些人呢，就是在你们成为奉献者之前已经结婚了，那么你的配偶呢不是奉献者，或者是呢，没有具有宗教之心。不具有这个 Krishna 知觉，那么这对于你在履行婚姻中的职责来说，可能就会受一些限制。
So, I'll give you a simple dharma if you're married.
就是如果你是已婚的话呢，我给你一个很简单的一个大马法则。
It be nice to your husband.
就是呢，你要对你的丈夫，就是行为举止比较良好。
Because sometimes
善待你的丈夫。
Sometimes if the woman is more Krishna conscious than the man, she's not nice to him because she thinks she's better.
因为有时候呢，就是这个妻子比丈夫呢，就是更加具有宗教之心，具有 Krishna 知觉，但是呢，这个妻子却不善待丈夫，因为她认为她比丈夫要优秀。
Anyway, we're supposed to be nice to all living entities, cats, dogs, mice, rats, insects, so at least our husband also.
所以呢，不管怎么说，我们要善待所有的生物体，包括那些狗啊、猫啊、那些老鼠啊、那些昆虫啊，当然也包括你的丈夫。
For a devotee,they never see their husband or wife as the object of their enjoyment.
对于奉献者来说，他们从来不把他们的丈夫或妻子看成是他们感官享乐的对象。
They always see themselves as servant. That's the qualification of being married.
所以呢，他们总是把自己看成是仆人，这就是。这就是他们就是说结婚所需要的这个资格。
Your husband, your wife belongs to Krishna, not to you. So you're a servant. Yes, that's it.
你的丈夫或妻子是属于 Krishna, 不属于你，你只是仆人而已。
So be a good wife, a good husband, a good parent.And then when your children grow up and they're older and they move out of the house, then at that time, you'll have much more time for your devotional service than you can give your full time to devotional service.
所以不管你是这个丈夫或妻子，然后呢，反正你是父母，当你的孩子长大成人，你已经就是搬出去家，他独立生活的时候呢，这个时候你就有更多的这个时间可以投入于奉爱服务当中，你可以全职的去做奉爱服务。
Also, we need to be a little detached from our children because they're individuals and they may not always become what we would like them to become. They're independent.So they're going to make their own choices and decisions. And we can only control that a little bit, not entirely.
所以呢，作为父母来说呢，我们也需要对孩子变得不依附，因为孩子他有自己的这个自由意志，他们有这个个人的选择，他喜欢去做什么。所以呢，对于父母来说，我们可能对孩子有这个很少的这个控制权，不能说完全的去控制孩子。
If you look at Prabhupada, he wanted his family to support him, but he didn't get much support from his family.
我们就看圣人帕帕的一生，他呢本来是希望他的家庭成员可以来支持他，但是呢实际上他却得到了很少的他家庭的这个支持。
So even a pure devotee maybe is not able to influence his children in Krishna consciousness as much as he would like, what to speak of us.
所以呢，对于纯粹的奉献者来说，他甚至都不能就是去影响他的孩子，就是按照他所希望的样子成为这个奉献者，成为他所要的这个样子，所以更何况是我们呢？
Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, you should see your house as Krishna's house.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 说你应该把你的房子看的是 Krishna 的房子。
It means everything is for his enjoyment.
那就意味着一切都是为了他的享乐。
Everything is used for him.
一切都应该是用于他。
Yeah, as far as possible.
尽可能的。
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has a song. Maybe
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 呢，他也有一个儿子。
Manasa Deha Geho.
他有一首，他创造了一首歌，大家有没有听过这首歌？
Manasa deha geho yokin chumo mind manasa deha
我的心意，我的这个我的躯体。
And geha means the home.
然后呢 geha 的意思呢我的家。
Mind, body, family, home, everything I give to you.
所以呢我的躯体我的家我的一切我都献给你。
It's yours, Krishna. I just take care of it for you.
Krishna, 这全是你的我只是为了你的缘故来照顾他们。
That's the idea.
这就是这个理想的一个想法。
Okay, next question.
下一个问题就是军人职业打仗，居士职业照顾家庭。伸手生的职责是什么 ？So, For a military, their duty is to fight. For a householder, their duty is to take care of a whole family. So what's the duty of a brahmachari?
Duty of the brahmachari is to do whatever the guru asks him.
Brahmachari 就去做任何孤乳要求他去做的事情。
Like an obedient servant.
成为一个谦卑的恭顺的仆人。
Prabhupada said, in traditional brahmachari ashram, if the guru didn't call the brahmachari for lunch, then he wouldn't eat lunch.
圣人帕帕的曾说，就在传统的 brahmachari 的 ashram 当中呢，就是如果这个 guru不让他吃午餐的话呢，他都不会进食。
And the brahmachari practices austerity and simplicity.
真守生呢，他需要奉行这个，苦行，而且是简朴。
And he doesn't talk to women.
而且呢，不跟这个女人说话。
Unless there's some service. Otherwise, he doesn't talk.
除非就是有一些服务要做，不得不讲话，否则的话呢，他不会跟女人不必要的交谈。
Now, somebody could say, well, I said the brahmachari does whatever his spiritual master asks. And that makes it sound like the grihastha doesn't do whatever the spiritual master asks.
就是当我说 brahmachari 呢，他们就去做任何灵应导师要求他们去做的事情，这听起来好像像是有一点感觉这个居士并没有去做灵应导师要求做的事情一样。
Not exactly like that, but a little bit like that.
其实并不是这样的，但是呢，多多少少还是有一点道理的。
But the brahmachari is like the menial servant of the guru.
就 brahmachari 呢，就像是 guru 的一个非常谦卑恭顺的仆人。
They live very simply. That's also part of being brahmachari. Very simple. They don't have much.
Brahmachari 呢，生活非常的简朴，他并没有拥有很多。这就是 brahmachari 他的生活。
Maybe two or three sets of clothes. That's all.
可能就只有两三套衣服，就只有那么多家当了。
One or two pairs of shoes, one plate, one bowl, one spoon, one Bhagavad-Gita, one book bag. One jacket, yeah, that, like simple.
可能就一两双鞋，然后呢，他呢有一个碗，然后呢有一个勺子，然后呢还有一套薄伽梵歌，然后呢可能有一个那个，就是一个很简单的一个行
李。You know, you understand. This is China. You know the monks. You see all the monks, the little boy monks. You know, like that.
你们中国人知道，在中国可能见到那些小和尚，你们看他的这个情况。
And do some tapasya austerity.
他们呢会去从事这个苦行。
And the brahmachari learns everything he needs to know in life. He learns as a brahmachari.
就是呢。作为 brahmachari 来说，他需要学会在生活当中所需要知道的所有的一切。
How to take care of himself, how to cook, how to be a man, how to be a husband. He learns everything.
就比如说如何做饭，就是如何成为一个男人，然后呢，如何成为一个丈夫。所以呢，他这些都是他需要学习的。
Next question.
Next question, in also the same devotee, he continue ask the, can we say that, maybe we are lazy in the material duty, but we are very diligent in spiritual duty.
Yes.
是的，可以这样说。Just like brahmachari don't have a material duty, they devote their full time in a temple to do spiritual duty. So they are responsible and they are very diligent.
But they shouldn't be irresponsible materially, brahmachari.
但是呢 ，brahmachari 在物质事物方面也不应该不负责任。
Excuse me for a minute.
Okay.
Hi. I just realized I have a meeting tomorrow when we're supposed to be doing kirtan, so I have to. rearrange that. Okay. Yeah, I totally forgot. I have a meeting. Okay.
刚开始的时候忘了。
We're supposed to have kirtan every Sunday at 10:30 in the morning, which is 10:30 at night for you in China.
他每周日的上午10点半, 他们都会有一个 kirtan, 就在中国时间应该是晚上10点半了。
But I have to think. I might have some other people do it for me. Yeah. Anyway, I'm just thinking.
Okay.
Prabhupada wanted us to be responsible in everything, spiritual and material, even if we're brahmachari.
他巴呢想让我们无论是在物质事物还是灵性职责当中变得有责任心，哪怕是对brahmachari。
Because you have so many duties in the service of Krishna, even if you're brahmachari, so you have to be responsible.
因为呢，就是作为brahmachari呢，你在Krishna知觉当中，你肩负着这么多的责任，所以必须要负有责任心。
What time is the sunrise in China? 5:30?
中国日出是几点呀？ 是大概6点吧,
six a.m.
I think.
就是在泰山的话, 大概四点多钟, 就是不同的地方它会有一点不一样。
Okay, so it depends on different places.
Mm-hmm. I think if we did this class in the winter, it would be perfectly timed that as it's getting dark here, it's getting light there. We would be able to watch on Zoom. My getting dark, I can see the sun. It'd be interesting. Yeah, the winter is probably like.
我说如果可能在冬季的时候呢，就会有一个非常有意思的现象，就在入木房间，我们可能就观测到，就是我们这边日出，然后咕噜那边日落，这样的情景。
Okay, so what other questions?
还有今天的问题 Lilara, 你能够读一下吗?
我那个等一下，稍等一下啊，蒋木兰，你看不到吗？我给你读一下啊，我看一下，或者我发到你那边，我发到你的微信上好吗？啊，我能看到，我能看到了。
Okay. 第一个是 Sambanda Das. 灵修中怎么能知道哪种服务是我的Dharma? 是派书,是厨房,还是什么?
So in spiritual practice, how can I know which service is my Dharma? Book distribution, cooking, or other service?
Cooking, what else? What was, say that again.
Book distribution, yeah. Cooking, or what else? How can I know which service is my Dharma?
You can discuss with senior devotees.
你可以跟年长的奉献者来讨论这一点。
You can look at yourself and try to understand your nature.
你可以就是分析一下你自身，看看你的这个天性适合做哪一种服务。There's
so many things you can do.
有那么多的你可以做的服务。So
we have to look at what inspires you, and we have to look at what is your nature, and we have to look at what is necessary, and then we make a decision.
我们需要就是说，分析一下自己我们的这个天性是什么，然后呢？ 还有就是什么服务能够激励我们，再加上哪些服务是必须的。
Sometimes they're practical considerations.
有时候呢，我们需要做实际的考虑。Right.
All the devotees are hungry, and you know how to cook, and you don't want to say, yeah, but it's not my dharma to cook, so we'll just all fast today. No, you... You'll cook anyway because that's what's necessary at that time.
就比如说呢，这个就是就餐的时间到了，然后大家都很饿，然后呢，你也会做饭，但是呢，这时候你可能就不会说，你不去烹饪，不去为这个大家这个做饭，然后我们大家都一起节食吧，你不会这样说，因为这个烹饪的这个服务在当下就是必须要去做的，否则的话大家都需要节食了。
Everyone has a nature also.
当然了，我们每个人都有天性。
Somebody likes to organize, somebody likes to serve, somebody likes to teach.
有些人喜欢组织管理，有些人喜欢去做服务，有些人呢喜欢去教学。
Somebody likes to do business.
有些人喜欢经商。
So, for many of us, we understand, we know what our nature is, we know what we like to do, and then we employ that in Krishna's service.
对于我们大多数人来说呢，我们就是说知道我们的天性是什么，我们知道我们喜欢做什么，然后呢，我们就把我们的这种天性呢，喜欢做的事情去利用起来，去服务 Krishna。
And sometimes we have to just do what is necessary and practical, whether we like it or not.
有时候呢，不管我们是否喜欢，我们都需要去做，需要去做的，而且特别实际的一些服务。
And if you don't know what to do, you can ask your guru.What do you think, Guru Maharaj, what do you think my dharma is?
如果你真的不知道你的 dharma 是什么的话，你就可以去问你的 Guru. Guru Maharaj, 我的 dharma 是什么呢？
Guru Maharaj, what would you like me to do?
Guru Maharaj, 你想让我做什么样的服务？ Okay, so...
But I think another point is all of you should have service. You should not live a life where you don't have service, or you like you only have service when your guru comes, and the rest of the time you have no service. That's not healthy.
所以另外一个要点呢，就是我们每一个人都需要有自己的服务去做，不是说，你不可能就是度过你的一生却。不做任何的服务，就是还有一种情况是非常不健康的，就是说你只有在你咕噜来的时候你才去做某些服务，当咕噜不在的时候你就不去做服务了。
One way you can please Prabhupada is by introducing people to Krishna consciousness.
就是其中你可以去取悦圣人帕巴的一个方式呢，就是你去把 Krishna 知觉去给予其他人。
Somehow or other.
不管以什么样的方式。
That's the highest dharma.
这是最高的 dharma.
Dharma. Dharma. Can you say that?
Dharma. Dharma.
Dharma.
Dharma.
Yeah, something like that. Dharma. Dharma. I don't even know if I'm saying it right, but it's close. Dharma. It's your
dharma.
Dharma. Dharma. Another question? Another question?
Yeah, next question. Panchatattva, Dharma, Adharma, Svardharma, 如何区分? So, how can we distinguish between Dharma, Adharma, and...Svadharma.
Well, dharma, adharma, it's in the scripture.
Dharma 和 adharma 呢，在经典中有所论述。
And it's in Prabhupada's instructions.
而且呢，也在帕巴的训示当中。
So, in that sense, dharma and adharma is referring to following scripture or not following scripture.
所以呢，就是 Dharma 呢，就是去遵守经典，然后呢 ，Adharma 呢，就是不去遵守经典。
And then Swadharma is referring to your specific duty according to your specific situation.
Swadharma 呢，就是根据你的特定的情况，指你具体的这个职责是什么。
Sambandha was asking that question.
Panchatada va? Ask a question.
No, the last question.
Oh, 就是上一个，对对，上一个是那个 Sambada Prabhu 问的一个问题。
That's Swadharma. My own, yeah.
这就是他的这个大吗？
You want to think how you can best serve Krishna according to your ability.
你呢需要知道根据你的能力你如何最好的能够服务 Krishna。
That's the highest dharma. How can I use my abilities best to serve Krishna?
所以呢这就是我的 dharma, 就是我如何能够运用我的能力去最好的服务到 Krishna。
嗯哼，When Prabhupada came to America, he wanted to preach that your Swadharma is to serve Krishna. That's the transcendental Swadharma. That's the highest dharma. Just that's the essence, devotional service. He wasn't saying, okay, you're Brahmins, you're Kshatriyas, you're Vaishyas, you're Shudras. He was just saying everybody serve Krishna. So he wanted us to find our position of what inspires us within devotional service.
所以呢，就是上人帕巴德当他在这个美国的时候呢，最初他对他的这些门徒说，你们的这个最高的这个斯瓦达玛呢，就是去传播这个 Krishna 知觉，就是不管你们是处在这个居士Brahmachari 啊居士啊还有任何的阶段你们就需要根据自己的能力然后呢根据自己的这个天性去从事这个奉爱服务。
You have a billion people, more than a billion people, that don't know about Krishna in your country.
在我们国家呢，有超过十亿的人不知道 Krishna.
So you have to use your intelligence. How to educate them.
所以呢，我们就需要运用我们的这个智慧，如何去教育他们
？That's your dharma.
这是我们的 dharma.
Our dharma as servants of Prabhupada is to help everyone become Krishna conscious.
我们作为圣文帕巴的仆人，我们的这个 dharma 就是帮助每一个人都。Mm-hmm.
There are thousands of ways you can do it according to your nature.
根据你的这个天性的不同，有这个成千上百种这个方法可以做到这一点。
Right, just like some of the devotees made a recording in China. I think who made the recording? Gopi Gita or?
就比如说有些人，有些奉献者在中国他。做这个录音
and Gopi Gita maybe who was it? No, not Gopi Gita.
I mean,
Grace and one other devotee made some nice recordings because they're good musicians. So that's just an example. You're good at something, you like to do it, and you do it in a way that can help other people become Krishna conscious.
就是在中国呢，有奉献者呢，他们就是制作一些唱片、一些录音，然后呢，因为这是他们喜欢去做的事情，他们就去这样做，然后呢，做这件事情可以帮助到他人，可以变得具有亏欠的知觉。
So Krishna consciousness means you have a duty to practice sadhana, and you have a duty to render service that in some way will help directly or indirectly others become more Krishna conscious.
就是呢，在 Krishna 知觉呢，我们的这个职责一方面呢是需要去，从事我们自己的沙的呢，同时呢，我们也需要去做出某些服务，直接或间接的可以帮助到他人变得更加具有 Krishna 知觉。
Because a devotee lives for the benefit of others.
因为呢，奉献者他的是为他人的福祉而活着。
I just got a new light. Let me go.Bring that light in. I just had to order another light. So give me 1 minute. I'll bring it in and I'll be lighter for you.
我再去拿一个灯光，这样的话呢，就他房间光线就会更好一点。
Maybe too light, but maybe a little too light, right?
It's okay.
dramatic lighting. A little too light. A little too close. Yeah, it's too close.
Too close.
Anyway, I ordered a light, like,that would go in front of me, but it turns out the company is like bogus, they don't exist. So I never got the light. I ordered three things when I came back from India for doing broadcast.
Yeah.
And they never sent them.
already paid?
I paid and they said, we already sent it. And, like, and then I go online and I look and said, these are bogus websites.
Wow. 姑就说她从印度回去之后呢，她就在网上订购了，就是两三件，就是用作她的这个直播的，这些道具，但是呢，她在网上已经付了钱了，这些公司其实是假的，然后却收不到货。
And you know where the it's either that or maybe the problem is they're in China and they can't send it out.And they don't communicate. They still have it, and they can't send it out of China. Maybe that's the problem.
或许呢，这个，you mean you ordered from China online?
Maybe I don't know for sure if it's from China. It might be, and maybe they can't ship it. Maybe they can't ship it because it's from China.
也有可能就是咕噜是买的是中国公司生产的，
Possible,
然后呢，因为现在。Yeah. 现在因为这个
Is that true?
现在的
From China still?
Yeah. It cannot be transferred.
Maybe that's the problem. They were companies in China and they can't ship it.
Yeah. That's a big problem. 就是一个有可能是他是买了中国公司的，然后呢就没有办法现在运到美国。
You'll have to get it for me and fly over yourself and bring it to me.
所以我们自己得想办法看看能不能直接飞过去 把这些道具带给咕噜
I forgot about these products and then Sita said well what do you need I'll get it for you and then I just remember these are three things I never got so maybe we'll get them a little light that would just go in front here so when it's dark like this
本来咕噜已经忘了他买的这些东西了后来呢Sita David 就提醒了咕噜问咕噜有没有他所需要的这些道具然后呢咕噜又想起来了他说如果他前面可能放一个这样的灯光的话呢他那个房间光线会好一些
Otherwise I have this that doesn't work It's not a photo light
Okay.
Okay, Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu. All right, we have other questions? Or let's say we can go for 10 more minutes?
Okay, 我们再多 yeah, there are more questions.
Okay.
Okay. 下一个问题还是 Samanda。
Samanda Prabhu。Samanda Prabhu 问，在服务中遇到某一服务，如何知道这个服务是我应该做的或者不是我应该做的，超出能力的。So maybe why do some devotional service, how can I know right this service is what I should do or this service is beyond my ability? How can I know?
Shimona, can you show your, can you show your, put your video on? It's easier for me to understand you if I see you.
Okay.
So you can say that again.
Okay. So why do a devotional service? How can I know this service is I should do or I shouldn't do because it's beyond my ability? So how can I know?
Well, sometimes it's a good question.
是一个好问题。
Because sometimes...If something is beyond your ability and you try to do it, you can create problems.
因为有时候如果某些服务超出了你的能力的话，你去做的话呢，就会带来一些麻烦。
Like, let's say I know how to cut hair, and I decide, because I know how to cut hair, I can do heart operations also, because it's just scissors. That would be stupid. You understand what I'm saying? I know how to use scissors to cut hair.
Yeah.
So then I say, well, if I know how to use scissors, I can do heart surgery because I could cut open.
Okay. 就有时候，比如说我们可能会有这样愚蠢的想法，我觉得我会理发，就说明我会用这个剪刀。那么我同样可以用剪刀来做这个心脏手术。
But if we say, well, Lulu, why don't you?Speak to some friends about Krishna consciousness, and you say, I can't do that. And I say, just try. Because if you fail, there's no loss, and Krishna will probably help you. So in situations like that, you can say, okay, let's try.
就比如说我可能问 Lulu, 你或许可以去跟你的朋友来介绍 Krishna 知觉。 Lulu 可能会说我做不到这一点，然后我说你为什么不去尝试呢？可能他真的就去尝试了这样去做，然后呢我就鼓励他，会对他说，即便你失败了，但是你又会有什么样的损失呢？毕竟 Krishna 会一直帮助你呢，所以呢他就这样去做了。
Or your spiritual master asks you, do this, I want you to do this, you think I can't do it, and he says no, try.
或者你的灵性导师想让你做这个服务，然后呢你说觉得自己做不到，然后呢灵性导师就说为什么不去尝试一下呢？
Because the problem is sometimes you think you can't do something that you can actually do if you surrender more to Krishna and let him guide you.
有时候呢就是你觉得你可能做不到某件事情，但是如果你更加去皈依 Krishna， 去让 Krishna 知道你这样做的话呢，你可能就会做到了。
So we have Prabhupada's example again. He comes to America.
那就比如说我们拿圣文帕巴的来举例，他去到了美国。
Krishna, help me.
然后呢，他就双手，就是皈依的这种姿态。Krishna, 请帮助我。
I can't do this myself. It's too difficult.
我自己真的做不到，太难了。
And if he fails, no loss.
即便你失败了，也没有任何的损失。
If Prabhupada comes to America and he fails, there's no loss.
即便帕巴的当初他去到了美国传教，结果他失败了，没有任何的损失。
But if he doesn't fail, it's great victory.
如果他没有失败，那么就是一个巨大的成功，巨大的胜利。
So, in many cases, there's no loss in trying. There's only loss in not trying.
所以呢，就是在这种情况之下呢，就是你如果去尝试的话，没有任何的损失。你不去尝试，才会是巨大的损失。
And sometimes, as we were saying before, the effort itself is your success. You tried, so that's your success.
嗯，就像我们之前所提到了，你只是去尝试，这个尝试本身就是一种成功。
But to try to do some service that requires high level qualification, which you don't have, then that would be foolish to think I'm, you know, it's like, that would be like thinking I could fly.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Oh.
我这边Guru的画面是固定的。
我也是定住了，我也是。
不知道怎么回事。啊，Guru最后说的就是说，如果有一件服务的话，超出了你的那个能力，当你去做的时候呢，你本来就是，没有这样的资格，就是，没有这样的资格去胜任这样的服务。但是你仍然勉强去做的话呢，这其实有时候，是一种愚蠢。
库鲁现在不在线上了，库鲁掉线了，
大家就稍等一下吧。我看一下还有几个问题。
我那个问题可以跟阿缪的问题一起问。
你的问题？
对，就是。对，就是阿缪问了一个，就是那个怎么区分自己目前做的事情是在那个达尔玛的圆圈之内？然后我的问题是，圆圈会不会越来越大？
好的。
嗯，
还有 Harry， 孩子成年后父母还有义务负责他们的生活吗？成年指那个到达18岁之后是吗？这个成年，李丽萍作为妻子完美履行自己的职责，就是服务好不管丈夫，只是去服务他吗？OK。行，大家稍等一下，咕噜现在，他那个那边掉线了。今天应该就这么多问题是吧？
哎，麻烦再重复一下刚刚咕噜说的那个。解答。
咕噜说到一半的时候掉了。他就是最后讲的，就是说，如果，就是我们去做一些超过我们能力的，就是我们没有资格，没有。
Hare Krishna, Maharaj just called and he said the internet connection.His internet connection is not working, so that we will end the class now, and he will let know what about the kirtan tomorrow, if he's going tomorrow at 10 East or not.
Okay. So we'll end this class.That now?
Yes, he lost the internet connection. He doesn't know why. He said that last week it was the same problem.
Okay. 因为 Guru Maharaj 呢，现在他的这个网络的问题，他现在暂时连不上。如果看看大家的话，能不现在就是结束我们这个讲课，我们遗留的问题呢，可以到下一周再回答。再加上Guru明天他还有他的这个 Kirtan 的节目，所以说可能今天的这个讲课就先到此结束。
好的，好的，那我们今天的课程就到这里。谢谢 Anuradha， 谢谢你帮我。Thank you Anuradha， Thank you for recording for us。
Thank you so much。
那我们今天就到这里，那剩下的问题呢，就下周好吗？
下周我们把这个问题记下来，然后呢我们下周的时候来回答。
好的好的，那谢谢大家的参与。
谢谢
大家的聆听，
谢谢大家提出来这么多的好问题。那我们下周，
谢谢。Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna See you next week
See you.
See you. Bye.